Let's talk about a question that a lot of people have been having since the release of Chaos Raids, and that is, are Chaos Raids too difficult? Now, this can be a difficult question to answer because, of course, everybody is going to be at a different level of experience with the game. So if you're a more hardcore player or you're somebody who has been extremely well prepared for Chaos Raids for several weeks now and you're in a really good guild full of 10 people who are clearing it easily, a lot of the things that I say in this video might not really apply to you, but nonetheless, let's at least just talk about it for a little bit. Now, this is going to be a little bit different of a video as well. I don't usually do these discussion type videos. Usually I do guides or tutorials or stuff like that. So I only ask this when it's a new video just to get some feedback. If you guys end up liking this kind of video, leave a like after you're done listening to it. Or if you don't like it, leave a dislike. But if you do that, just let me know any feedback or things that you guys want me to do to improve these types of videos in the future. So with that being said, let's get into a little bit of the details behind Chaos Raids and why a lot of people might not have expected them to turn out the way that they are. So first of all, let's get into the minimum gearing requirements. I want to focus on gear for the time being. There's a few different things that I want to talk about. Gear, then actual mechanics, and then the fact that you're now in a group of 10 people instead of just being in a group of 4 people or doing content alone. There's a really big difference between those three things, and those three things all combined together really kind of make Chaos Raids as difficult as they actually are, at least for the time being anyway. So first of all, let's get into the minimum gearing requirements. So if you open up the Chaos Raid window, you'll see that it's asking for a minimum of 4,500 gear score. That is the actual requirement in order to enter. And then it's actually recommending that you have a plus 11 weapon. So these minimum requirements and these recommendations have definitely been very, very controversial because a lot of people say that they're just too low. And I absolutely agree with that. I think that they are too low. However, I'm really curious to see in the near future, because this is still the very first week of Chaos Raids, the minimum requirements really are the absolute minimum. That is the absolute minimum that you would ever even think about going inside of a Chaos Raid. And right now, it seems absolutely impossible to do Chaos Raids with plus 11 weapons. If you take a full team of 10 people with 4,500 gear score and plus 11 weapons, even if people know what they are doing and you have a really good team, people are not dying to the mechanics, it's still pretty much going to be impossible. Now, I'm wondering in the future if after people have mastered the mechanics and mastered the fight even more, and there really truly are no mistakes, people have completely optimized team compositions and different mechanics of the fights like adds, I wonder if it will be possible with the minimum restrictions. As of right now, that does not really seem to be the case. I feel like the minimum for the first Chaos Raid is more along the lines of plus 12, plus 13 weapons, and things really do get a lot easier when a lot of people in your group have 13, 14, or even plus 15 weapons. But plus 11 just really does seem to be way too low of a recommendation. So I think that if the game were to, instead of say plus 11 was the recommendation, that plus 11 was like the absolute minimum, I think that would be a little bit more clear. But as of right now, when you do open up the Chaos Raid window, it says minimum requirement 4,500, recommended weapon plus 11. So when it actually comes to gearing as well, a lot of people have the actual weapon. They have a plus 12, plus 13 weapon. A lot of people have 4,500 plus, even 5,000 gear score. But there's a lot of pieces of gear and a lot of focus on gearing that a lot of people overlook. And I am actually guilty of this as well. And that has to do with the actual stats and optimization of your gear. Now, generally speaking, your weapon is going to be the biggest creep in terms of power. If you can manage to get your weapon from, say, plus 13 to plus 14 or plus 14 to 15, that's going to end up giving you the biggest chunks of power. But there's a whole bunch of other chunks of power that you can give your character without actually increasing the level of your weapon or increasing your actual gear score. And that is just maximizing the bonus attributes of your gear and kind of taking a look at that. Now, after doing a little bit more looking into it and doing a little bit more testing, piercing is definitely still, without a doubt, the best bonus attribute, but the most important thing when it comes to your gear on Chaos Raids is not just having a ton of piercing, it's just making sure that on all of your gear you don't have bonus attributes that aren't really doing anything for your character. So on my gear, for example, a lot of my gear has only one bonus attribute that really does something good for my character. Like, I'll have attack speed, and then I'll have you know, increased some damage that doesn't really, that I can't even do, or some reduction from something that doesn't really help me out at all. So a big power boost that you're going to see in your character when it comes to gearing up is just replacing a whole bunch of the bonus attributes on all of your gear that really aren't doing anything for your character. And it doesn't even have to be anything specific. I think for the longest time, a lot of people were putting way too much focus on piercing or specific stats. As long as it's just something that is going to be really helpful for a character, things like piercing, boss attack, attack speed, you know, total damage, anything that is just going to be really, really useful for your character, as long as you're replacing one of those stats that just doesn't do anything for you at all. And then, of course, accuracy as well is going to make a bit of a difference, but just optimizing the stats of your gear and not just worrying about the plus stat and the actual gear score of your character. Now let's get into a little bit of the actual mechanics of the fight, because this is something that a lot of people were very caught off guard by, especially in the early footage of Chaos Raids, where it was a little bit difficult to really tell how unforgiving the mechanics are. And when it comes to Chaos Raids, the mechanics are definitely very unforgiving. And by that I mean, if you go into a hard mode dungeon, for example, let's just take Fire Dragon, because that's probably a hard mode dungeon that a lot of people are very familiar with. If you go into a hard mode dungeon and you end up getting hit by something, it's probably not going to kill you. There are some mechanics like the laser beam and Fire Dragon can end up one-shotting you, but most of the mechanics aren't going to just kill you right away. You can get hit by it, and it's not really that big of a deal if you do. In fact, if you're more experienced and you're really well geared, a lot of people will even purposely get hit by stuff because it's not really that big of a deal and they can just continue DPSing. Now in Chaos Raids, at least with epic gear right now, that is not the case. Pretty much all the mechanics in the actual encounter will either one-shot you or come very, very close to one-shotting you. If you stand in anything, you're dead. If you end up getting hit by the laser beam, you're dead. Not only that, but making sure that you're absolutely on top of the additional mechanics, things like adds, especially the healing adds, super, super important. There's really no wiggle room in terms of the mechanical elements of the actual raid itself. And because you're now in a group of 10 players, which is a huge thing that I want to talk about, it's super, super important for everybody to know what they're doing, to know what their roles are, to not only be really well geared, but to just have a really good handle and grasp on the actual raid itself. Even if you end up having a few people who really don't have a very good idea as to what's going on, that is all that it can take for you to turn your solid raid group into a complete disaster. And now, of course, in my opinion, this is the absolute biggest contributing factor as to why Chaos Raids are a lot more difficult than people think they are. And it's because now, instead of being in a group of four players, in normal mode and in hard mode dungeons, we were in groups of four. So you were grouping with three other people besides yourself. Now we're in a group of 10 players. So you're in a group of 9 other players instead of just 3 other players. And that is a lot of people. I know people who are very accustomed to raiding in other games like World of Warcraft might already be used to it, but for especially more casual type players, being responsible for an entire group of 10 players and making sure that you can find 9 other people who all know exactly what they're doing, who are all very well geared, who aren't going to make mistakes. It's very easy in a group of 10 people for one or two people to end up making a mistake, whereas in a 4-player group, it's a lot easier to kind of get a handle on the 3 other people in your group. So that is going to be a huge contributing factor as to why Chaos Raids are very, very difficult as well. And I think one of the biggest things that I want to end up leaving as one of the final points of this video, and honestly probably the biggest reason why people think Chaos Raids are a lot more difficult, and why people's expectations were so different from before the release compared to now, is I think a lot of people were focusing on themselves individually before the actual release of Chaos Raids, and I was noticing a lot in world chat, just with friends, with people playing the game, everybody was focusing on their gear, they were focusing on their stats, they were focusing on their weapon, they wanted to get as geared as they possibly could, and they wanted to get ready, and they thought, you know what, if I get my plus 15 weapon, if I get my gear score to 6,000, if I get all my bonus attributes, it's going to be easy mode. But a lot of people failed to realize that, especially true in Chaos Raids more than any other content, it's not just about you, it's about your entire group. And while it's a lot easier for you to have a much bigger impact in a, say, a hard mode dungeon with 3 other people, you're gonna realize how much more damage or how much quicker you're able to clear something if you've got insanely good gear but 3 other people don't really have as good geared. In a 10 player group, it's gonna be a lot more difficult for you to really realize that, and you really do have to have an entire group full of people that are on the same boat as you. Everybody needs to be well geared. Everybody needs to have a handle on the raid. Everybody needs to know not to get hit by the mechanics. And it really is a 10 person, or I mean, later on, obviously in the future, you can do it with less. But as of right now, it really is a team effort. And looking at it as doing it individually and being an individual effort is probably the number one reason why people are upset with their progress so far in Chaos Raids. So obviously, it is still the first week. As time goes on, a lot of these things will change and things will get easier over time. But as of right now, there are still not that many people who are able to complete Chaos Raids. It's definitely difficult. It's a lot more difficult than people thought they were. But I would say before anybody asks for nerfs or changes or anything like that, I say give it a little while longer. And if you are one of the players who has been focusing mostly on yourself, try to focus on building up a team and getting everybody else, all the other people in your raid, kind of on the same page as you. That's going to make a huge, huge difference, because all it really takes in Chaos Raids to lead to a disaster is a few people not really knowing what's going on, and then that's pretty much going to be the end of it. So anyway, just wanted to talk a little bit about Chaos Raids, my opinion, my feedback, the things that I've gathered myself personally, as well as the experience of other players through watching YouTube videos and Twitch streams and discussion boards and all that stuff. So, of course, you guys are welcome to disagree with me. If you do, that's totally fine. Just let me know in the comments what you guys think about Chaos Raids so far. We are still in the first week, so, of course, a lot of this stuff is indeed going to change over time. But once again, if you guys enjoyed this video and this style of video, consider leaving a like. If you are new to the channel and you guys want more videos like this in the future, consider subscribing for more. And as I always briefly mention at the end of the video, if you guys are interested in the monthly giveaway that I host, we are getting close to about halfway through the month of November, so still get a while to go. Link is in the description. There are plenty of ways to enter, the two easiest of which be a subscriber to the channel for 2 tickets and leave a like on the video for a bonus ticket. It's going to be for a $50 Nexon NX or a $50 Steam gift card for Maple Story 2 Merit. So good luck to those of you guys entering that. And I did decide to end up giving away the 50 million mesas that I made through that mesa making video. I've been getting a lot of questions about that. So yes, I am giving those mesas away. I talked about it, I think, a couple of days ago. So if you are interested in that, feel free to check that out as well. With that all being said, thank you guys for watching. A few videos should be popping up on the screen if you missed out some stuff on the channel. But if not, until next time, this is Salt of the Salty Guild, signing out.